This is session 6 of Astrophysics. Myself is Dr. H.C. Manjunath, Government College for Women, Kolar. In this session, I am going to explain the photon diffusion time, mass luminosity relation, and the lifetime of a star. Photon diffusion time is the time taken by the photon to diffuse from the core of a star to the surface. These photons are released at the core of a star during the thermonuclear fusion reaction. In the thermonuclear fusion reaction, hydrogen fused to form a helium. During that, the photons are emitted. These photons emitted and the photon which is released in the released at the core collides with the atoms and the molecules, possesses a random like motion, finally it reaches the surface of a star. So that means the time taken by this photon to reach the surface of a star through this diffusion process, this is called as photon diffusion time. This photon diffusion time is total photon energy divided by the luminosity of a star. We can say this photon diffusion time for a sun is calculated as the 3.46 into 10 to the power of plus 12 second. This slide shows the small derivation of the photon diffusion time. This photon diffusion time is the ratio of the total energy radiated by the star to the luminosity. Total energy radiated by the star can be evaluated using the Stefan-Boltzmann's law, so that U is equal to 4 sigma by c T c to the power of 4. So this is the total energy density radiated by the star. The sigma is the Stefan's constant, velocity of light, r is the radius of a star, the small r is the position, and simplification of this, the total energy density is equal to integral of 0 to r u into du. We will get this total energy density of a star is 1 by 105 this multiplied with 16 sigma pi by c tc to the power of 4 r cube. Tc is core temperature, sigma is again Stefan's constant, r is the radius. And luminosity is defined as the energy flux multiplied by surface area. And the energy, this luminosity is defined in equation number 3. Energy density of a star is defined in equation number 2. Then this photon diffusion time is energy radiated divided by the luminosity. So substitute, that is equation 3 equation 4 equation 3 divided by equation 2 divided by equation 3 gives the photon diffusion time. After simplification, you will get 4r by 105c multiplied by tc by t whole to the power of 4. That gives the photon diffusion time of a star. This slide shows the mass luminosity relation. This equation gives the relation between the mass and the luminosity of a star. So, luminosity of a star is directly proportional to the cube of the mass of a star. This applies to the Mein sequence. This mass luminosity equation obeys only the Mein sequence star. The star which appears in the Mein sequence of the HR diagram, that is called as the Mein sequence star, that obeys the mass luminosity relation. And for the giants and the white dwarfs, it takes the form of L is proportional to m to the power of 4, another form of mass luminosity relation. Proof for this mass luminosity relation is given this in this slide. This photon diffusion time, from the definition of photon diffusion time, energy density divided by the luminosity. This luminosity is energy density by the photon diffusion time. So again, so this energy density is directly proportional to the what? Fourth power of core temperature, directly proportional to the cube of the radius of a star, and this Tc is proportional to m by r. I mean the core temperature is directly proportional to mass and inversely proportional to radius. Substituting this proportionality relation for the core temperature in the energy density, we will get E is this m by r whole to the power of 4 r cube. This r cube get cancelled, so total energy is directly proportional to m to the power of 4 and inversely proportional to the radius. And again, this photon diffusion time is directly proportional to square of the radius of a star and inversely proportional to mean free path. Now this mean free path is inversely proportional to the density. This density is of course the proportional to the volume. So this SC is mass divided, again the density here, mass divided by volume. So this mean free part takes the relation R cube by m here. Again this tau is proportional to again this after substitution of for the proportional relation for S, this tau takes the form m by R. Now substitute the proportionality relation for the photon diffusion time, which is defined in equation number 3, and the energy which is defined in equation 2 in 1, that gives the L is proportional to m cube. This R get cancelled, so L is proportional to m get cancelled, and 1 R get cancelled, L is proportional to m cube. That is the proof for mass luminosity relation. This mass luminosity relation enable us to study the lifetime of a star. So this mass luminosity relation says that luminosity is directly proportional to the cube of the mass of a star, and lifetime of a star is directly proportional to mass and inversely proportional to the luminosity. So in place of L, if we write the proportional relation m cube, 1 m get cancelled, lifetime is inversely proportional to the square of the mass of a star. That means most massive stars are having the shorter lifetime, and the stars whose mass is average having but the longer lifetime. So thank you for your kind attention.